Hi and welcome back. In this lesson, I will give you a little background of C programming language, its origin, why we should learn C in this 21st century, and what are the popular companies in this world which uses C as programming language. And of course, before we move ahead, give this video a thumbs up, and if you are new, please subscribe to my channel. Well, C was created in 1972 at Bell Labs by a famous scientist named Dennis Ritchie. And the development of C programming language is closely tied to the development of Unix operating system. Now, what is Unix operating system? Well, today we have Windows operating system and Macintosh operating system. Similarly, in 1970s, they had Unix operating system. And most of the components of this Unix operating system were written in B programming language, which is a programming language which existed before the C language. But this B language was really slow, and in terms of performance, it could not meet the expectation of Dennis and his team. So in 1972, Dennis started working on this B language, which eventually led to the creation of C programming language. So, this is how the C language was actually created by Dennis. And then, the entire Unix operating system was then written in C language. But the question arises, in 21st century, why should we learn C? Why should not we directly start learning programming languages which were created in this century? Such as Python, Kotlin, C#, JavaScript, PHP, and a lot more. So why should we learn C in this modern era? Well, the answer is really simple. Among these modern languages, a large number of programming languages are derived from C language. Yes, you have heard me right. These languages, along with several other languages, has either adopted or derived their control structure, syntaxes, and other basic features directly from the C language. So this is the reason C is also known as the mother of all programming languages. This means if you successfully complete this course, then you can learn any language you would like to, without facing too much trouble. Not only this, there are a lot of programming languages whose most of the modules and components are entirely or partially built using C language, such as Objective-C, Python, Perl, and PHP. So I hope now you understand the gravity of C language. Even today, many popular products use C, as well as its derivatives such as C++. Such as the Windows operating system uses C and C++. A part of Facebook application is built using C++. Popular application such as Adobe Photoshop is entirely built using C++. And to learn C++, you need to first learn C programming language. So C and C++ are always chosen in some way or the other due to their ability to deliver high performance. So that is why, if you go for the interviews of these product-based companies, they generally ask a lot of questions from data structures and algorithm based on C and C++. So if your foundation is not clear, they can reject you right away. Because these companies at the core heavily rely on C and C++ some way or the other. Fine. Now moving on, C is a very old language, so it lacks the capability to support object-oriented programming. But its shortcoming is fulfilled by C++ language, which fully supports object-oriented programming. So first, let's learn C and then C++. So yes, that's pretty much it for this lesson. In the next lesson, we will do some software setup, which are required to write programs in C language. See you there.